That's what it look like. I'm finna put it on because. Hey y'all, so this is my first video. It's gonna be a vlog, and I'm currently in Miami for my birth organization. Yeah, you really gotta get these cities done because I had two kids, and yeah, I'm young and hot and sexy. So yeah, gonna be in my kingdom. Yeah, so I had my pre-op today. I was supposed to record this morning, but it was a lot going on. It was too much. I barely got any sleep last night. So, yeah. But I had my pre-op today at 9 a.m. I had to pay for a drug test and a COVID test. And unfortunately, I had to pay to get a lab redone because they never emailed me and told me that, you know, my lab results were a little low and that I need to redo them and shit like that. So I had to get that redone. And yeah, so when I went today, they gave me my pre-op instructions. I can't eat 12 hours prior to surgery. So my surgery is actually tomorrow at 12:30, and I gotta be there 30 minutes before that. So I gotta be there at 12. So ain't no eating, nothing. It say no eating no gum, no candy, no water, nothing. So I don't know, but I'm finna eat. My last time eating gonna be at 11:30, maybe 11:45, so I could be well fed, and yeah, I don't got time. Yeah, so they gave me, so I paid. I ain't feel like ordering nothing before I got out here, so I just decided to buy everything when I got there. They gave me some compression socks. These were like $12 or something like that. They gave me these surgical bras. There's two of them in here. And they size you up when you get it. So it's not your actual bra size. It's going to be a little bit dull. It's gonna be yeah, I want to see what it looks like. I ain't even opening it. I'm going to look at it with y'all. Because I want to see. Okay. Okay, y'all. So that's the bra. It's not tight, it's a lot of space right here. So when they put the titties in there, we good, the girls gonna be sticking. But this part right here, I don't know about this, it's a little tight right here, so. But I did bring my own like clip front sports bras, just in case that this be too tight and uncomfortable. I don't have time to be tight and uncomfortable. But I'm gonna wear it. I'm gonna wear it for like at least, you know, the first 3 days or whatever. But after that, if it's uncomfortable, I'm gonna wear something else. Cause I don't think I should be uncomfortable after surgery. That don't make sense. But yeah, so we got that. What's this? That's just my receipt. But yeah, so 12:30 tomorrow. And I'm excited. I'm not nervous at all, y'all. Like, I'm honestly ready. I've been looking at my doctor for 2 years, and I'm not gonna tell y'all who my doctor is until like 6 weeks in with the titties, maybe, you know, after I see my results and stuff when I update y'all. But yeah, I've been looking at my doctor for 2 years. I was actually supposed to go to him last year, but he's real good. He was booked out like 180 days, and I was like, I don't even wanna wait that long. I wanted it done right then and there. So this year, when I called and tried to get my, you know, foot on my consultation and stuff, they got me in. I did my consultation in November. It's January, and I'm getting my surgery. So yeah. Yeah, that's all. I cut my hair because, you know, New Year, new me. P period, and it's giving. The girls is loving it. Everybody loving it because, yeah, I love it as fuck. Period. Don't need no hair. All natural. We don't need all that extra stuff. You know you're real cute when you could do pull off the shortcut. But anyways, I'm about to go get something to eat. It's going to be the only day I'll be able to do anything, I feel like. So I'm just going to go enjoy my day. And I will see y'all later. I'll take y'all on a little vlog of what I do when I get out. Okay, so I am back in the hotel. Hold on. This shirt is so like, we just gonna hit me with one of these right quick because I don't know what's going on, but whatever. Make it look like something. There we go. But yeah, so I'm back at my hotel now. I went and ate my food and I brought the food back and it is 10:33. Again, about like 30 minutes, maybe an hour, because you know, my last time eating is 12 o'clock, and I'm not gonna be hungry tomorrow before the surgery. I mean, I'm gonna be hungry anyway, but I don't wanna be starving, you know? So, I'm gonna go ahead and give me some food in my stomach, and yeah, I'm about to get ready for bed and stuff. Maybe not, I'm probably gonna be up. If I'm up, I'll update y'all. If I can't sleep, then I'll get back on here. If not, y'all know I went to sleep just fine, and I will see y'all in the morning. So, it's 1 o'clock in the morning, and I am, well, I don't know why I'm whispering, first of all, but it's 1 o'clock in the morning, and I'm nervous, yo. And I'm excited. I'm not nervous at all, y'all, like I'm from, but I guess because it's the day of, now, at this point, it's the day of, and I am so nervous, like, I'm panicking, I'm not gonna lie, like, I don't know, like when I go in there, I'm gonna try to just go in there, you know, with a clear head and just not think about that shit for real. But right now I can't even sleep because I'm nervous. Like I'm nervous. My heart is like nervous. But I'm about to try to go to sleep and hopefully I can't eat nothing. I can't drink no water. I can't nothing. Nothing. So I don't know, but I don't know why it keeps not focusing. I'm panicking, and I hope everything goes well. Wishing myself a safe, speedy, fast, you know, whatever recovery, because I don't got time. I feel like I have a pretty high pain tolerance, but I don't know for real. Feel like surgery is different. You never really know what your pain tolerance is when you're about to get cut open. But yeah, I will see y'all when I wake up in the morning. And hey y'all, so it's the morning of the surgery and I'm actually getting ready to go right now because it's 11 o'clock. I say I'm gonna get there at 11:40, so I'm feeling, you know, hurry up and get out of here. So I just want to reread this to y'all because, yeah. So it say, you know, no eating for 12 hours. So I haven't ate nothing since like 11:30 yesterday. No, yeah, like 11:30 yesterday. And I had water like 11:45. But it says no lotions, no perfumes, no deodorant, no nothing. So I just got out the shower. I took a shower with some Dial soap because that's what they said. And yeah, my skin is dry as hell right now. My face too. That's why if I look crazy, I look like a little boy and shit, you know. But so yeah, it says wear loose fitting clothing. So this is what I'm wearing because I know they say, you know, you're not going to lift your arms, nothing to pull over your head, nothing. So I'm gonna be comfortable. This is what I'm wearing. I got on some shorts under this, and then they gonna put on that bra on me after. And yeah, this is what it is. Then it says, please arrive. This part I didn't read. This is why I'm rereading it to y'all, because this had me like, what? It says, please arrive to your surgery on time, 30 minutes prior to surgery time, or a late fee. Bless me, thanks. Or a late fee will be applied. $300 of a late fee. Y'all think y'all finna get any more of my money after that shit y'all pulled yesterday? Y'all got me messed up. Y'all ain't getting a dime out of me. Again, I'm finna go ahead and get this surgery, and y'all finna do what it do. And I'm finna have some titties. But yeah, I just wanna come on here and update y'all real quick. I'm actually really nervous still. Actually, I don't think I'm nervous anymore. As nervous as I was this morning. This morning, I was like panicking. But right now, I feel a little more chill, a little more calm, relaxed. You know, I ain't too tripping too much. I think because it's actually time, you know, I'm like, yeah, let's just go ahead and get it over with. Let's go get some titties, y'all. But all right, I will see y'all when I get there. I'm going to try to vlog real quick before I go in. Because I know I'm not going to be able to take nothing in with me. So I'm going to just go ahead and try to give y'all a quick little vlog. Like, hey, I'm here, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I'll see y'all when I get there.
I'm here, surgery time, and I'm scared, y'all. I'm nervous. I'm so nervous. Okay. I don't know why I keep. Yeah, they can hear me. But I'm about to go in there. They said the procedure is only an hour, and then I get picked up. I'm so nervous. But I know everything's gonna go well. And I'll be good, and I'm gonna wake up with some titties.
So I just met my doctor, and my little thing that they gave me just ripped. But I just seen the doctor, and I'm next. He's gonna go in a few minutes, and I'm gonna go into a pool seat. And yeah, I look crazy. Yeah, I'm so nervous, and I'm whispering because I'm not supposed to be recording. But who cares? Who doesn't record surgery? Yeah, I'll see y'all when I come out of surgery.
I just got out of surgery, y'all. I just made it back to the hotel. The pain, like a 6 out of 10. My back just hurt real bad. My arms hurt. Titties, they don't really hurt that bad. I think my incisions burn a little bit. I think I feel that. But the girls are sitting, and they look just how I looked before I had these churn. And I can't even laugh, y'all. So I ain't even gonna. We ain't gonna do that. But yeah, I feel okay. I can move my hand like this, like I can use my phone and stuff. But lifting like above my elbows. When I woke up though, like before they, like when I woke up after surgery, y'all, I was crying so bad. Like I was crying so hard. I'm like, is my boyfriend here? Like I wanna go home. Like I'm crying so bad, like so bad. I'm having a whole panic attack. Like, I just couldn't stop crying. They're like, it's normal, it's okay, you're okay, you're gonna be okay. I'm like, can you hold me? Can you hold me? Like, I'm boohoo crying. Can you hold me? Can you hold my hand? Please, give me a hug. Like, I'm just boohooing, like, going crazy. But, like, after, I guess, you know, they know what they talk about. Because after I calmed down and I guess the anesthesia wore off, I was chilling. But while the anesthesia was on there, I was panicking. But the doctors know what they're talking about. My doctor did what he said he was gonna do. Give me back the fullness that I want. I got a full seat. And they look, like I said, they look just how they look before I had kids. So I know this ain't my final results, but I think they're gonna look real good. So, yeah. And I can taste the medicine in my mouth still. They gave me some medicine right before they put me to sleep, and I can taste that shit. But yeah. Later, y'all. I'll update y'all later after I take a nap and stuff. I just came out here to update y'all how I'm feeling and stuff. I just woke up like 10 minutes ago. Woke up a little more sore than earlier. And more so just in my back. Like imagine my boobs being like in my back. That's where I'm having the pain. My right arm. I've heard that your dominant side, basically like side that you write with, side that you really do the most with, like I'm right-handed, so that boob is more higher and swollen than the other one. So my arm, my right arm, I can't really lift it. Like I can do this, and like the other one, like I can do this, and I can do like this one. I can raise it a little more. This one, I have to literally like hold my arm because I feel like if I let it go, it's gonna hurt so much. And like, you know, naturally when your arms are down, your arms swing a little bit. I can't do that right now. So that's where the pain is too. My chest feels a little tight now. Like, that's why I'm talking, I feel like. They say you're supposed to take 10 deep breaths, an hour, and walk around for 5 minutes every hour. So that's why I'm standing up in the bathroom doing this video right now, getting my blood circulating and breathing so that, you know, following doctor's instructions so that I can have the best recovery. I can't feed myself, so my boyfriend been feeding me. What else? I'm musty, y'all. Like, I'm putting the clip that I posted on Instagram, but I'm musty.
Y'all know Miami is too hot to not be walking around with no deodorant. I bitch musty over here, okay? I bitch my is sweating. I'm fucking musty. Yeah, I said it. So yeah, I'm glad.
Like, my underarms, because you know when I took a shower this morning, they said don't put on no lotion, no deodorant, no nothing. You just got to be clean, dry skin, you know. So I'm a little musty or whatever. My boyfriend said my breath stink. That was earlier, like when I got back and stuff. He said my breath stink, which is normal because the medicine coming out of my body, whatever medicine that they gave me through the IV, because I tasted it when they gave it to me. So it's that medicine. And my pee stinks too. Like, it's like, it don't stink, but like, it's not like medicine coming through it. Like, it has that little like medicine odor type thing. Yeah, I'm just sore. To describe how my titties feel, I would say they feel like if you're a mom and you breastfed or you just felt how it feels to have milk fill up in your boobs, that's how that feels. Nothing too overwhelming. I mean, when I was breastfeeding and the milk filled up in my boobs, it was very overwhelming, but that's how it feels. Like, it's bearable. Yeah. That's really all so far. I still have on my compression socks. Obviously, still have on my bra. My post-op appointment is tomorrow at 12:30. So I'm gonna be up and early to head over there. I can't take a shower for 24 to 48 hours. So I'm just, obviously it's gonna be after my pre-op appointment tomorrow. My post-op appointment tomorrow. I'm just waiting for them to tell me when I could take a shower. Let them look at my incisions or whatever they're about to do.
I'll let y'all know what they finna do when I go. But yeah, I'm just finna walk around a little bit and eat the rest of my food. I kind of really don't have an appetite, but I just know my body needs it. And especially if I'm gonna keep taking medicine, I always personally feel like you're supposed to eat when you take any medicine. Otherwise you'll have like a stomach ache or a headache or anything, you know? Like, I just feel like you're supposed to eat before you take medicine. So I've been eating a little bit. I was able to feed myself right after surgery. I had some chicken wings. But now, like, I'm eating some salmon and shrimp, rice, mashed potatoes, and asparagus. And I can't feed myself right now. Because, like I said, my right arm is my dominant arm. And I can't really, like, stab the fork and stuff because it hurts. You do a lot more with your arms than you actually think when it's time. But, yeah, I'm about to brush my teeth, go for a little walk, get some water so I can stay hydrated, drink a lot of fluids. And yeah, that's it. So far, like, I'm looking at my boobs and they look pretty good. Like, I like it, you know. I'm pretty happy with my results already. I'm so drained, y'all. Like, I feel so, my body is tired. I'm not tired, I just woke up from a nap. But yeah, so I'll update y'all later. Maybe take y'all on a little walk with me. And yeah, see y'all later.
Why are you so close?
Bruh.
I was in the back, but people are smoking back there. I don't want to be around that right now. I just went to my pre-op appointment, and they want me to come back in a week, but I'm not coming back because I'm leaving for the week. So, I have to go to my primary care doctor so they can take my tapes off and remove my stitches if they need to be. And no driving for a week. No lifting my arms past, like, I can't even lift my arms, honestly, right now, so. But no lifting my arms past, like, right here, like this. This one is higher than this one is starting to drop and settle already. This one has to drop and settle. I can take a shower today, but I can't wash from my tanks. So, I'll take a little bird bath. Swelling to get around so I can be back and moving and doing stuff for myself. I brushed my teeth myself this morning. It was hard, but I did it. Yeah, that's it really. Yeah, we'll get back to the hotel.
Hey y'all, so I just got back to the hotel. Well, I just got done eating. And clearly I wanted to show y'all what the girls is looking like from what you can see so far. But I just got back from my appointment, and they just, like I told y'all before, I can't really lift my head. That shit, they told me not to lift my hands above my head for a week, and then sleep on my back for a week. I gotta keep on these compression socks for a week. Gotta wear my bra for 2 months. The bra is actually really not that bad. Like, it's not that tight and uncomfortable. Like, I've watched videos where girls be like, these bras are so uncomfortable. It's not that bad. Like, it's just a bra. The only thing I probably would say might be uncomfortable is because it's so snug against your incisions. But I feel like it's supposed to be. Because if it's loose, you don't want to move it. You know, you just want to keep everything in place. So that's how I personally feel about it. But I just ate. I ate some Chick-fil-A. I was able to feed myself that. What else? They took my bra off, so I did see my boobs. I've seen them. So this one is settling faster than this one, as you guys can probably tell. Maybe, maybe not. But this one's a little higher. And so we're just waiting for this one to drop. They said in a week. I'm not gonna be here in a week, so in a week I'll go to my primary care doctor for her to take off the tapes and you know, check the stitches and stuff, make sure everything is going good or whatever. And yeah, so they gave me a little instrument. Okay, so yeah, so they gave me this card. It's, I got 385 cc's in both boobs. This is my receipt of my surgery and stuff. I didn't really read it, but that's what it is. Yeah, I'm gonna take my meds because she told me, like, you know, make sure I take the muscle relaxers. It'll help, and my antibiotics. It'll help with the swelling and helping this boob, you know, drop down a little more because it's still pretty high. So yeah, other than that, can't complain so far. Love the titties. They look super natural. Exactly what I want. I want titties sitting up high on my chest. My boobs never naturally sat up on my chest, so that would be pretty weird. But these look really good. They feel really natural. You're not supposed to play with them. But she squeezed them when I went to my appointment, so I was like, shit, let me feel it too. I did what she did. And they felt really good. Like, yeah, real natural. But all right, Alaria. So I just took a shower for the first time. It is 7:11. This is, you know, the same day after my post-op appointment. And my titties, they look great so far. This one's still a little swollen, but it's going down. And this, the titties is tittying or whatever. You can kind of see them through the shirt, you know? Yeah, I bought this shirt right before I came out here because I was like, I need something that I can zip up so I ain't gotta put nothing over my head or nothing like that. I'm very bloated. Like, my stomach is super bloated right now because my stomach is naturally like really flat. But yeah, so I'm about to go to Walmart. Cause, you know, just to go for a little room for a little while. And yeah, about to go to Walmart, get some snacks, get some waters, cause I feel really thirsty and really hungry all the time. And then we're gonna get something to eat, come into the room and chill before I take more medicine and be knocked out again. Cause that's all I've been doing. Medicine, sleep, eat, repeat. Yeah, so I'm gonna take y'all to Walmart with me and show you what I get.
So I'm at Walmart and I'm looking for some sweatpants and, you know, a little sweater to put on, and they don't have nothing. All of these clothes is big as hell. Like,
so I am currently a couple days. Well, it's been, let me see. I ain't been counting exactly, so let me just count. It's been, well, today's day 2 post-op, and this is what the titties are looking like. This one is still really swollen. Like, it's really sore still, like, to do anything on this side, really. I've been just trying to work it out a little bit, you know, doing little movements, trying to get the soreness away. But this one is settling pretty nice. Falling into place, about to start fluffing. I think I feel good. I'm waiting on my food right now. I've been able to get up better out of bed by myself. At least sitting up. I've been able to sit up by myself. I brushed my teeth again this morning by myself. I used the bathroom by myself for the first time. Other than that, like the pain, not really no pain. It's more so soreness. But I'm still going to take my muscle relaxers because you know what muscle relaxers are for, little muscle spasms or whatever. Because the implants are under my muscles. So yeah, I'm going to keep taking those until I feel like I don't need to anymore. I'm extremely bloated, like really bloated. My stomach is naturally flat, like I told you guys yesterday. So this is a little weird, I don't know, but I know this is normal after surgery. I've done my research for 2 years before I even decided to go ahead and just do this. So, I'm okay. I'm doing good. I wish I had more to tell y'all. But if you guys have any questions that y'all want to ask me, then feel free to ask me in the comments or ask me on Instagram or anything like that. And I'll go ahead and put together a new video for my, like, maybe 2 week, 3 week update. I'll probably do a 3 week update because that's when I can go back to doing activities and stuff. So I'll do a 3 week update and you guys can leave me questions below that you want me to answer or DM me on Instagram. I'll post a little poll thing on Instagram. And yeah, let me know what you guys want to hear, what you guys want to know, what you guys want to see. It is the same day that I started this video or whatever, telling y'all that I brushed my teeth and stuff. It's 9:44 and I just changed my bra because my surgical bra is really, 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 really tight. Like really tight to the point that it was like creasing like in my skin. So I don't think that's okay. Like I don't want my implants to be moving all type of crazy and stuff. So this bra is really still snug. It's really snug still. It's compressing. It's good. Like it ain't loose at all. But it's more comfortable for me to be in. And it actually feels way better. Like I can move my arms a little more than I could with the other bra on. So I like this one better and I'm gonna wear this until tomorrow. And if I feel like there's a difference, you know, if I feel like maybe I need to go back to my compression bra, the surgical bra, then I'll go back to that. But for right now, I think this is where I need to be because my boobs are starting to drop already. They're starting to, the swelling is starting to go down a lot. Like a lot. So I think this bra is better for me right now. I'm still really bloated. Like I look like I'm having a little baby. But I really do though. But yeah, I got a lot of gas. Like I've been real gassy. I've been walking around. I walked outside, walked downstairs. Just getting my blood circulating and stuff. Cause earlier I didn't feel too good. And I haven't taken any medication. The only medication I took today was a muscle relaxer. That was earlier, I want to say around like 3, maybe around 3. But I haven't taken no medication since then. So pain wise, I've been really good because I don't even feel like I need to take any medication. I'm still going to take my antibiotics and I'm still going to take my muscle relaxers for bed because I need to be able to sleep because I'm not going to be able to sleep. Having to sleep on my back is so uncomfortable and like, yeah, it's just not working. So I'm going to take a muscle relaxer for bed and yeah, it's helping this side go down more because this side is way higher like I was telling you guys. It's way higher. Let's see if you see. You can see the swelling right here. Versus this side, it's more like, and like it's really swollen right here. like a nerve. I don't know, but there's like a nerve in my arm that hurts really bad. So I'm hoping by Monday, I'm able to do more with this arm because it hurts and I want to be able to move it. It's my dominant side. It's what I do everything with. But if not, I leave Tuesday. So if I don't feel better by Monday with my arm, I'm probably gonna go back to my doctor and see if they can do anything or whatever. And just to make sure everything's okay before I get on the plane and go. But other than that, yeah, my appetite has increased a lot. Like after surgery, I've been eating like 3-4, wanting to be eating 5 times a day for real. Like my appetite has gone up a lot. And hopefully it stays like that because I'm trying to gain weight, y'all. So that's gonna be another thing that I'm gonna put on my channel. I'm trying to gain weight so y'all can go on a weight gain journey with me. I got a gym membership. I've been going to the gym. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to sit the gym out for the next 3 weeks. But once the 3 weeks is up, I'm back in there because your girl gotta be thick by these vacations I'm trying to take. I'm trying to go to. I ain't gonna see y'all where I'm gonna go. We're just gonna leave it at that. And when it's time to go on a trip, I'm gonna take y'all with me on a trip. And that's just gonna be that. But yeah. Other than that, these are the boobs so far. Can't do too much, but I can do enough. And I'll see y'all tomorrow.
So, I'm day 3 post-op, and I'm going to the nail salon to get my nails done because, yeah, I need to be looking like a bad bitch. It's time to start looking like a bad bitch again. So, I'm about to go get my nails done. And I found this nail salon. They do nails really good. Like, real, real good. I'm going to show you.
Part 2 gonna be me leaving Miami, getting on the plane, going back home, how it is at home with my kids, because I gotta go back home to them. Even though my mom is still there to help me and stuff. But I still gotta go back to them. So this is gonna be the last clip. Obviously I look better. I'm talking more normal. I feel better. I feel good. Like I'm talking a lot with my hands. But I got my nails done. They look cute. I mean, they okay. Me being a nail tech, they did all right. Like, let me let it focus. They did all right. I could have did it better, but no shade, no tea. My boobs, I switched back to this bra because the bra that I had on earlier, it definitely helped. Like, it's not leaving this bra now. Isn't leaving any creases in my skin anymore. Like, I really feel like I needed to switch for like that little period of time that I did because it helped a lot with my swelling. Like, this one went down a lot more. And y'all can see. Let me focus. But yeah, y'all can see or whatever. I don't know if y'all can see. I'm blind, y'all. I really should be wearing my glasses for this video, but I don't like wearing my glasses. And my contacts, the day of my surgery, I had them in. And you know you're not supposed to wear contacts for surgery. So they had me take them out and put them in the contact solution that they had. And I don't know what kind of solution it was that they had, but it turned my contacts like this green kind of color. So I didn't really want to put them back in my eye because that's not, it don't look right. So, dug in blind for the video. So when it keep getting blurry, I can't see, I can't tell because all I see is blurry. But, yeah, I feel good, y'all. I haven't taken any pain medications today at all whatsoever. Well, besides this morning, like I told y'all, when I went out to the nail salon, I took it then because I was going outside and I didn't want something to happen and I don't have my medication with me, you know? So I just took it. But since then, I haven't taken anything but my antibiotics. And yeah, I feel really good. Like, I feel really good. I can't stop touching my boobs. But I, like, I'm not supposed to touch them, so I just be like resting my hand on them. But like, they feel so good already. And I can't wait till they heal, because when they heal, y'all ain't gonna get enough of me on Instagram. Oh yeah, it's over with. It's prepare to see titties all down your timeline, because I ain't paid for these for no reason. Yeah. So, I'll catch y'all in part two. Like, comment, subscribe to my channel. Let me know what videos y'all want to see. Like, whatever you want to see, no matter what it is. Because this, my channel, going to be everything. Like, I don't plan on sticking to one thing. You know, like, everybody has their own lane. My lane is everything. I'm good at a lot of stuff. So, y'all ain't just going to see one thing, because that wouldn't be me. That wouldn't be me just sticking to one thing. So, y'all going to see everything. So, meantime, like, comment, subscribe. Tell me what y'all want to hear. I know I keep repeating myself, but I just feel really good, y'all. Like, I just feel really good. But catch y'all next time.